You couldn't ask for a more perfect day for matinee baseball here at the Big A. It's the rubber game of the series between your Angels and the division-leading Texas Rangers. Hi, everybody. From inside the Big A, we welcome you back to Angels Baseball here on Fox Sports West. I'm Victor Rojas, along with my partner, Mark Gubza. Last night, we were treated to a very special inning, the sixth inning for the Halos, scoring six runs, down five, and able to take a 9-8 lead at that point, turning the ball over to the bullpen. Scott Downs, Jordan Walden got the job done, but going back to that sixth inning, the second time this season the Angels have scored that many runs in one inning.
Yeah, Vic, I like their approach to that particular inning. Mickey Hatcher, the hitting coach, before that inning, and said, hey, guys, let's get a better fight at the plate. Let's go up there and hit that fastball. It started off with Howie, and of course, Mike Trout showing that tremendous speed, beating out that infield hit, and it continued from there. Guys with their better approaches, getting themselves into good hitters counts, able to score six run. Howie again coming through with that clutch base hit. Twice came up with the bases loaded last night. Twice came through with a big base hit. And of course, able to win that game. Scott Downs did a great job in the seventh and eighth. Walden closed it up. But it's all about the offense there in the sixth inning, scoring those six runs. A better approach to the plate, not swinging the pitches out of the zone. When they're doing that well, getting in fastball counts, the success rate goes up for this ball club.
Well, this afternoon, the Angels turn the ball over to Jared Weaver. A great pitching matchup. Weaver will be going up against the left-hander, C.J. Wilson. We're just about ready for baseball here at the Big A, so sit back and relax. We'll bring you the lineups in the first pitch when we return. Baseball is brought to you by Hyundai. People are talking about Hyundai. Uncensored. See what they're saying at mysocalhyundai.com. by CarMax. Now more than ever, the smart choice is CarMax.
Beautiful shot down on the pier, but here at the Big A, it's even better because baseball is just about ready to be played. The Halos have taken the field. Jared Weaver just beginning his warm-up tosses right now. We'll take a look at the starting lineup for Ron Washington and the Texas Rangers. They sit atop the Western Division of the American League with a four-game lead over the Halos at 56-42. Ian Kinsler will lead things off. He's at second base. Elvis Andrus at short. Josh Hamilton and Laugh Adrian Beltre is the cleanup hitter at third base. Michael Young is the DH. Nelson Cruz in right. It's Mitch Moreland at first base. Mike Napoli back behind the plate. He'll bat eighth, and Andy Chavez will bat ninth and play center field. This is the same starting nine that Ron Washington ran out there in Tuesday night's game. This lineup, however, taking on Jared Weaver, who has been spectacular all season long and even better over the last 10 games.
Boy, he's been throwing the ball so well, establishing his fastball, that no-seam fastball inside against left-handers. Excellent changeup, curveball, slider, getting a lot of quick outs on that fastball early in the count. 6-0 in his career at home against the Rangers. Which has been throwing so well anywhere. In the home and road splits, been outstanding for him as far as ERA.
Defensively for the Halos, Hallie Kendrick, Mike Trout, Vernon Wells from left to right. Alberto Callaspo and Eric Ibar on the left side. Meister Sturis, Mark Trumbo on the right. Jeff Mathis will catch Jared Weaver this afternoon.
And Mike Trout out to center field. Generally, the baseball carries a little bit better during the day, and Jared Weaver more of a fly ball strikeout pitcher. So the defense up the middle, so imperative for Weave to be successful. You have a great one there in center, and you have also great up the middle as far as Eric Ibar and Meister Sturis be able to turn double plays.
Ian Kinsler swinging at the first pitch. Pops one up to shallow right center field. Mike Trout comes in, makes the call on the catch. One pitch and one out is how we start this rubber game of the three-game set. Texas winning game number one on Tuesday, shutting out the Angels by the final of 7-0. And then last night, the six-run sixth inning we just spoke about, paving the way for the Halos to take game two 9-8.
That was a fun game last night, the way to come back like that, down 8-3 in the sixth inning.
Isanori Takahashi picked up the win in relief, his third. Jordan Walden picked up his 22nd save of the season as Elvis Andrus takes a fastball upstairs for ball one. Andrus hitting 280 with three home runs, 34 runs batted in, went 0-4 last night. And he's ahead of the count here at two balls and no strikes. Walden, by the way, with that 22nd save, tying the Angels' rookie record set by Ken Tatum back in 1969. 2-0, it's in there. It is 2-1. We'll take a look at our Hyundai key to the game.
I'm going with some yes today for you, Victor. It can happen. We saw that last night, to come back, and all of a sudden the confidence going for this club against this Texas Ranger team who had won 12 straight ball games. It's that consistency at the plate, and of course then you have your ace on the mound to try to win the series.
This one chopped over the head of Alberto Callaspo. Nothing he can do there as he's headed toward the corner. And Andrus is on board with a one-out double. First hit of the series for Elvis Andrus. It's 13th double. That ball bounding very high, just out in front of the plate. You can take a look at the area in front of home plate. Very moist, very wet still, so still a big bounce. Being able to clear Alberto Callaspo and a man in scoring position for the Rangers here in the first inning. And that's been the case in the first two games of this series. Texas having scored solo runs in the first two games of this series.
And Jared certainly has to keep an eye on Andrus at second. He loves to try to steal third, but Jared does have five pickoffs, including one at second base.
Josh Hamilton at the plate. The first pitch is down and in for ball one. Hamilton's got a little four-game hitting streak going. 2-for-5 last night. Picking up an RBI. His 54th. A 303 average. 13 home runs on the season. Off-speed pitch. A wave and a miss. That's one ball, one strike.
And that's a difference maker for Jerry Weaver, having that ability to throw a changeup in a fastball count. First pitch, fastball in off the plate, then threw a great changeup at 79 miles an hour.
Down and in. It's two balls and one strike. Hamilton's been hot, especially with men in scoring position in the month of July. He's tied for the American League lead with 18 runs batted in this month. completely healthy. Spent some time on the disabled list earlier this year. Pickoff attempt, no throw from Weaver. May or may not recall the play at the plate on a foul pop-up on the third base side at Comerica Park against the Tigers, in which Hamilton tagged and tried to score. Head first dive, ended up having a non-displaced hairline fracture of his right shoulder. The 2-1. Swing and a miss. 2-2. This is the first time the Angels have seen Hamilton in a series between these two teams, having been on the disabled list the first two times when the Angels were down in Texas. Time is called. Mathis called time as Weaver was starting to come set. A one-out double for Elvis Andrews. He stands at second base. The 2-2 just missed off the plate.
Boy, that was a good spot. And just off the corner, though, it's good eye for Hamilton when you consider that changeup was just on the same plane on the outer half. Be able to take that one.
Check swing on the breaking pitch. He did not go on the appeal. Jim Wolf says he didn't go. It's a walk for Jared Weaver. So two on and one out here in the first inning for Adrian Beltre.
He's able to hold back on that slow curveball down and in. And Jared had an open base, forcing Hamilton to swing at his pitch. Hamilton with a good eye did not waver from his approach at the plate.
Adrian Beltre went 2-for-4, had a double and an RBI last night. Takes the breaking pitch a little bit high. That's 1-0. Beltre hitting .272 with 20 home runs and 75 runs batted in his first season as a member of the Rangers. One and one. The outfield straight around for the Angels. Vernon Wells deep and right. A pickoff attempt at second base. The ball in the dirt. Nice dig by Asturias, but no play.
Good idea, though. That shortens up the lead for Andrews at second base. And the thing about Jared is really worked hard over the last year or so as far as slowing down the running game against him. It's 6-7 with his delivery. Very easy for a good base dealer to try to steal a base, but he's been able to work on his pickoff move and holding the ball very well.
Runners go. Pitches a strike to throw down from Mathis. Is it time? Two outs.
When there's no question that pickoff move before that at second base shortened up the lead, slowed him down just enough to give Jeff Mathis a good chance to throw out Andrews to third base. Very good transfer for Mathis to be able to get him. And a good throw, clear path to third base, and Hayes was able to apply the tag.
A 1-2 count on Beltre with Hamilton standing at second base. Check swing foul back over the screen. Here's the tag and the slide.
Boy, a sweep tag at third base too. A better view right here. It is a tag being applied as the heel is just about ready to touch the base at third.
Hamilton picks up a stolen base on the back end there, and it's his sixth of the year.
Thank you.
Beltre goes down swinging. That will end the inning. No runs, a hit, and the Rangers leave a man in scoring position. We hit to the bottom of the first, scoreless here at the Big A. Start the bottom of the first inning for Mike Socia. The Halos four games back at 52-46. Meister Sturr is back in the lineup. He's leading things off at second. Eric Ivar is at short. Torrey Hunter will serve at the DH today. No Bobby Abreu with a left-hander on the mound. Vernon Wells, the cleanup hitter in right. Alberto Callaspo at third. Howie Kendrick in left. Mark Trumbo at first. Mike Trout at center. Jeff Mathis doing the catching, and he will bat ninth. Taking on the 30-year-old California native by the name of C.J. Wilson.
Boy, he does have a good fastball from that left side, 90 to 94 range. Very good slider, swing and miss pitch. With that one, of course, the developing changeup, which he's really worked hard on this spring training to be able to throw to right-handed batters.
Wilson making his first All-Star team. The guy that gave up the home run to Prince Fielder at Chase Field. Said he was struggling with the feel of the baseball in the Arizona desert as Asturias takes a fastball for a strike. CJ has been just as red hot as Jared Weaver. Last 10 games, a 6-0 record, a 2.80 ERA. Asturias chops one to the left of Beltre. He lets Andrews handle this one. And Asturias is retired for the first down. Let's take a look at the Texas Rangers defensively behind CJ Wilson. Hamilton, Chavez, and Cruz from left to right. It's Beltre, Andrews, Kinsler, Moreland from third to first, Napoli behind the plate.
Boy, and Josh Hamilton has an above-average arm out in that left field position. Very, very aggressive. One error so far this year in his 128 career starts he has in that left field position. Generally a center fielder, but a guy that can cover a lot of ground in left field.
One ball, one strike count on Eric Ibar. Had a 2-for-5 game last night, a double and an RBI. Hitting 287, 7 home runs, 41 driven home. That pitch is inside. And it's 2 balls and a strike. Eric Ibar with hits in 11 of his last 12 games. Getting it back going. Let's take a look at the umpires for this afternoon. DJ Rayburn is calling the balls and strikes. Ron Culpa at first. Darrell Cousins, the crew chief, at second. Jim Wolf is over at third base. A 3-ball, 1-strike count on Ibar with Torrey Hunter on deck. Ibar takes the walk. So the Angels get their first base runner here in the first. And that'll bring up Torrey.
one thing C.J. Wilson has improved on is his walks. Last year, averaged over four walks per nine inning. This year, around three walks. He's going to live on the outside part of the plate. The approach against him is look away, change up away, fastball away. He will throw a cut fastball inside on a right-handed batter, but his bread and butter is down and away.
Wilson's a guy also that can get his pitch count up early. Deep counts as Torrey takes down low for ball one. Went seven innings the last time out against the Seattle Mariners, allowing a run on five hits. Struck out seven and walked three. And a guy who was very dominant against left-handed pitching last year. I mean, almost impossible if you're a left-handed hitter against him. As Torrey gets jammed, floats one out to shallow right, and Ian Kinsler makes a terrific play and hangs on to the baseball.
Well, that's the thing, to be able to hold on to that baseball as he dove out it when the ball landed in his glove. He hit the grass and still able to keep the grip on the baseball in his glove. Reads it well, dives, makes that play. Kinsler's a guy that not necessarily great range at second base, but very good as far as going back on pop-ups.
Nice athletic play for the Rangers second baseman. Two outs here in the first. Ibar still at first. And here's Vernon Wells. We're just getting back to the point of the splits for C.J. Wilson this year. As a matter of fact, he's pitched better, or he's fared better against right-handed pitch hitters this year than he did last year. Lefties hitting him at 268. Righties at just a 231 average.
Well, last year, lefties hit about 150 or 160 against him.
Vernon takes a fastball down and away. One ball, no strikes.
He is susceptible to the stolen bases. Allowed 15 stolen bases against him. Zero pickoffs, which is an unusual number for a left-handed pitcher. Generally, left-handed pitchers have that quick move to first. It's more of a show move over the first, not a real good move.
Check swing. It doesn't matter. It's a strike on the outside corner. One ball, one strike. Vernon getting to start in right field today with Torrey serving as a DH. Vernon had one hit last night, went one for four. 218 all the year with 14 home runs and 35 runs batted in. Seven doubles, one triple. 1-1 inside. It's two balls and one strike. Wilson is a guy, as we've seen already here in the first inning, not afraid to come inside, but for the most part, his bread and butter is living on the corners.
He does a combination of sink, fastball, changeup, same plane, outside corner.
Here comes the 2-1. Vernon chops it foul. Evens it down to two balls, two strikes. Ibar still trying to get his feel over at first base against Wilson. Third start for Wilson against the Angels this year. His first two starts down in Arlington. He's compiled a 1-0 record, a 2.25 ERA. Got a no decision. And the one start in which he left with a 4-2 lead. Left some base runners on board. The Angels ended up winning that game. Vernon takes inside. It's a full count. Ibar will be off with the pitch with two outs here as Callaspo hangs out in the on-deck circle. Alberto's been red hot swinging the bat. There goes Ibar. The 3-2 is chopped slowly towards short. Andrews comes in. He will retire Vernon Wells for the third out. One complete here at the Big A. We have no score. Top of the second here at the Big A. No score. Jared Weaver here to face Michael Young, Nelson Cruz, Mitch Moreland, and it's our pleasure to welcome in former Angels right-hander and one of People Magazine's most beautiful people in the world. What was that, 1991? Kirk McCaskill kind of joined
us. I have no idea what you're talking about.
You had no idea I was going to bring that up.
That's why you still have the article on the wall
at
home?
Wallpaper.
Yeah.
How have you been?
Been good. Yep. Appreciate it. Yeah, living down in the San Diego area now, North County. Just about an hour from here, so everything's going good.
You get a chance to come out and watch some games, whether it's here or down at Petco Park?
I do. I see some Angel games and some Padre games. Got, a lot of former players living in my area, so, still staying in touch through those guys and through, watching the games.
Yeah, last few times we talked, you've been coaching some Little League baseball. So how's that been going for you as far as being that coach?
Well, Gooby, I'll tell you, as I was just telling you, the kids are great. Unfortunately, their manager blew it for them this year. Little League All-Stars, it was a blast. But, we were kind of three and dones. But yeah. We were ready for a big summer of baseball, and I wish we would have been able to continue that. But, I love coaching the kids and do a lot of that.
Still love coming out to the ballpark and getting a chance to reminisce a little bit with former guys, whether it's former teammates or otherwise.
Well, it's more like former teammates' kids now. Mm-hmm. I'm at that age now where all these guys' kids are coming in and playing. But how the season is such a grind. You don't get to see the guys as much during the season as you would hope.
You watch a guy like Jared Weaver. I know you were a very successful pitcher in your career. Well, you used to that center field position making plays behind you, too, with Gary Pettis.
Devon White, right?
Yeah, Gary Pettis, Devon White. Yeah, you can't beat that. That was my style of pitching right there. Hope they hit it at somebody or near somebody, yeah.
You can see that great jump that Mike Trout was able to do. And you mentioned those guys out there patrolling center field for you. But bottom line is, when you look at a guy like Jared Weaver, one of the best changeups in the game. I mean, you were a guy that, you had the power fastball, you had a good breaking ball, but his changeup and his ability to throw it to both righties and lefties consistently is something pretty special.
Yeah, along with his size and delivery, I think, he's got a little bit of funk in there that just throws guys off. But, I believe in that changeup as well. And even though I didn't have a good one, I know how critical it is for a young pitcher. So, as we teaching the kids, you want to go teach a changeup first before you teach anything else.
Yeah, I was going to ask you about that as far as Little League. Parents always want their kids to throw big curveballs and stuff. And that's one thing that I tried to help out with the younger kids is the changeup is, for me, is probably the most important pitch outside of a fastball.
Yeah, exactly. I think you want to go fastball command first. If you can teach them to throw to the four corners and learn how to command their fastball and then go to the changeup and then wait till they get a little bit older before you start dealing with those other secondary pitches. Absolutely. Well, yeah.
From a pitching standpoint, you see a guy like Jared Weaver at an early age. What do you do with him? If you see a guy that successful with kind of, as you pointed out, odd mechanics.
Well, at a really young age, I think every pitching instructor would try to change some of those mechanics to get a young kid to throw less across his body, more in line with the target, things like that. But you just can't argue with success once kids get to a certain age. And obviously you wouldn't try to change anything that a successful high school or college pitcher would do unless it jeopardizes their arm health.
So get back to your golf game now, all the guys down there in the San Diego. I know you play a lot with Bud Black. How often do you play against him, and who really is able to win those games when you go out there and play?
Well,
I know Victor wants to go out and play with you pretty soon, by the
way. Yeah, well, you know Blackie. You know him well. He's a guy that cannot play for like 5 months and come out and take your money. But there are a lot of guys down there that play a lot of golf. There's as much golf as you want down there, Victor. Come on down.
We've heard the same thing about you, that you kind of just lay in the weeds. You're one of those guys, and you're asking for pops on both sides.
I'll take shots wherever I can get them.
Yeah, that's what I understand. And then you kind of just
that's part of the game.
To them, right?
Part of the game, yeah.
As long as we play for minor league stakes.
Yeah, nothing heavy. Nothing, and I lose so much that I don't bump up the stakes.
Can I ask you about your ceremonial first pitch? No Letterman jacket. I mean, one of the first? There's been a handful of guys.
Well,
that's
anybody that's
move,
smart,
by the way.
Yes,
exactly.
Well, it is. I think it's 90 degrees today. That jacket would have been a little difficult, but that was a thrill. My 12-year-old son got to come out and catch it. He was excited about it. I was excited to be there with him on the field. So it was really fun, very exciting.
Were you throwing at somebody in particular there? That was a little up and in.
Yeah, I was throwing at my oldest son there.
I thought perhaps you were imagining Gooby batting from the right side before you guys came up to the booth.
Yeah.
I don't know. I heard you guys
You wouldn't do
tough.
That to me.
No, you're too tall. Too tough. Too big.
Any desire for you in the future to kind of maybe get back into organized baseball and teach, whether it's as a rover or as a pitching coach?
Well, you know, I think yes. You know, my youngest son is now 12, and I definitely made a commitment to stay home with my family after I retired until the guys were gone. So, you know, possibly in the future, yes.
I mean, that's got to be something you would, I mean, you've known a lot about that as far as pitching mechanics and stuff. You'd be able to help. Your delivery was pretty much textbook. I have to give you that for that, because the fact is you were always out over that front leg and you were never flying open. You didn't have weird mechanics like Weaver or myself.
Yeah, Gooby, your mechanics were underrated. We'll leave it at that. But,
is that the term you guys used back then?
Yeah, underrated? Very underrated mechanics. But, you know, today there's so many instructors out there and pitching coaches, and I think, you know, one of the advantages that you and I had growing up was we used to just watch guys on TV and try to do what they did, you know, and it was almost easier.
Yeah, every kid now has a coach, a hitting coach, a pitching coach, but it's those mechanics you teach that sometimes, in my opinion, just aren't the right mechanics, but it's because you're in some, you know, academy or something, you all of a sudden you're certified, you know what you're talking about.
Yeah, and I think ultimately what it does is it sort of just takes the athleticism away from the kids, you know, and you want them to go out and be athletes, but they get, you know, you see 10, 11, 12-year-old kids sort of, you know, pitching robotically, and to me that doesn't work.
Yeah, I got to ask you, as a child or as a young man, you played hockey, you were a goalie. And back in the late 80s, Jack Lazorko also came up as a goalie. Who was the better hockey player between the two?
Well, Vicar, I was not a goalie. I'm not stupid. Never played catcher, never played goalie. I was a forward. But I remember well Jack Lazorko on this mound acting like Grant Fuhrer quite a few times with line drives
the
up the middle, making those, yeah, leg saves.
Did that hurt your legs watching him get down like that?
Yeah.
I mean, he had that low center of gravity to begin with. I mean, he wasn't a very tall guy.
He did. You know, he was actually, even though it was funny to watch, he was a great, great fielding pitcher. He really could field his position. And he also had the best first to third pickoff move in the history of the game.
Really?
Yeah, he was quite a character. And but he was very, very good at it.
That's our favorite move, by the way.
Yeah. We've
tipped our hat to Steve Busby over there. Does it. He's the one that so-called invented that move, the third to first move, which was always something I can honestly say I never got anybody. Did you ever get anybody on that?
I don't remember getting anybody, but I remember I probably tried 1,000 times.
Yeah.
It's amazing how you just beat your head against something. Whether you get called from the dugout or you try it yourself, you think you're going to outsmart somebody.
Well,
always says pitchers are the smartest guys on the field.
And best athletes, right?
Best athletes by far. We know that. but in my situation, I had a hard time getting outs at the plate, so I needed to get outs out there on the bases, so I tried everything.
Yeah. It's all about the ancillary things going on, right? As opposed to things you can actually control. two outs here. Base hit by Mitch Moreland extends the inning for Mike Napoli. Now, obviously, when you picture the stadium, a lot different. How did it play back then compared to today? Was it similar? The ball flies during the day here. Nighttime, obviously, with the marine layer and everything. Kind of
always has. It's always jumped here in the daytime. And but I was telling my family coming up when I was my youngest son's age, at 12 years old, I actually used to ride my bike up here from Huntington Beach and watch the Angels play on some Saturday and Sunday games. And when the stadium was more like this, so this is what I grew up with. And then obviously when I was playing here, it was filled in because the Rams were here. So always a pleasure to come back to the stadium and see it open like it was in the late 70s and in the early 80s.
Yeah, we're looking at this matchup, Weaver versus Napoli, former battery mate. And we were talking about this the other day. Was there any time when you faced a former catcher that got yourself in a position where you weren't throwing strikes because you were afraid because that guy's going to go along and think what you're trying to get him out with?
I think most of the catchers I've faced couldn't hit, so I had the advantage.
There you go.
Hey, Kirk, we really appreciate it, and
thank you.
I'll take your money anytime.
Okay. Come on down and play.
Thanks, Toby. We're at the bottom of the second with no score. Cast through his first two innings. C.J. Wilson issued a one-out walk in the first, but Eric Imbar was stranded at first base. Here in the second, it'll be Kiyosbo, Kendrick, and Trumbo. Thanks again to Kirk McCaskill for joining us. Taking time out of his busy schedule to come up, throw the ceremonial first pitch.
Well, one of the best. You talk about a competitive guy on the mound. You can tell he has that hockey player's mentality when he went out and competed each and every pitch he threw on that mound.
I can't believe he skated on that People magazine.
He was quick to get away from that
he,
one.
He was bobbing and weaving. Kiyosbo bounces one over to Beltre. Sidearm swing over to first, and there's the first out of the second. Fans, follow the Halos at foxsportswest.com/angels for all the latest team news, and be sure to vote for the Angels poll question. The best 1-2 starters in Major League Baseball this season. See them listed right there, and that includes Weaver and Heron, even though Dan scuffled yesterday, giving up the most earned runs he had all season long in his 4 1/3. But as you like to say, he spit the hook. No decision for Dan Heron.
Well, that's a good feeling when you struggle on the mound and your offense is able to pick you up and you can just get totally refreshed and have your bullpen session tomorrow and be ready for your next start. It's never fun when it goes the other way, when you have a 5 or 6 run lead late and it goes away from you, though.
Like Derek Holland.
Yes. That's the old hang with him on that one.
Yep. Howie takes a strike and it's no balls, 2 strikes. Kendrick with a big game yesterday. Snapped his 1-for-18 with a 3-for-5 performance. 4 runs batted in. Pitch is down and in. And that got Howie. So it's a hit by pitch. On an 0-2 count, C.J. Wilson puts a man on board.
He does that a lot. That's his 8th batter he's hit this season. Majority of them are on that exact same pitch. Overthrowing the slider, getting the front foot of a right-handed batter.
So Trumbo steps to the plate with one out. Howie Kendrick standing at first. Mark had a base hit and an RBI last night, finishing off 1-for-4, hitting .259. Team leading 18 home runs, 44 runs batted in. He'll look at a fastball up and away, and it's 1-ball, no strikes. Just 4 games in the American League on this Thursday. One already in the books. Toronto defeating Seattle 7-5. Trumbo takes a strike at the knees. And it's 1-ball, 1-strike. Later on today, Yankees at Tampa, Detroit at Target Field against the Minnesota Twins.
Boy, Minnesota getting closer and closer. Part of that race now in the AL Central. Just 5 games back.
One is bounced foul. The count goes to 1-2. The White Sox continue to kind of scuffle, treading water, if you will. Just can't get on a prolonged winning streak.
Yeah, they got to that 500 mark, then they've kind of fallen back, win a couple, then fall back once again.
Throw over. Now he just a couple of steps off the bag as he gets back in there. Now you mentioned the lack of a pickoff for C.J. Wilson. Not a very good move. I mean, I came up as a starter through the minor league system, so obviously you knew that he was working on it at some point. Trumbo swings and misses. It's a strikeout as Howie Kendrick advances on that wild pitch. 2 outs. But just getting back to that, is we'll take a look at that strikeout pitch. Wilson then converted to being a relief guy. I wonder if that has any effects of trying to get back to the mentality. Relief guy going full bore.
Yeah,
your mindset is, I don't care about the base runners. I'm just going to try to get the hitters anyway.
That's why generally even closers, it's pretty easy to steal a base against closers because their mentality is, I don't care, I'm going to get a strikeout anyhow. But, you can see his move to first base is the lead so far for the base runners for the Angels are just waiting to see when his best move is going to be. Well, he hasn't shown that yet, but he doesn't necessarily have a very good move also. He's just kind of thrown it over to make you aware. But as a base stealer, you're thinking, okay, when is his best move going to be coming over here? He hasn't shown it yet, but he doesn't necessarily have a great one to begin with.
Is he saving it for like September? Perhaps. 0-1 pitch to Mike Trout. Nets lifted in the air toward right center field. Andy Chavez moving over, and he drops the baseball. Howie Kendrick comes in to score. The Angels are on top, 1-0.
And that's the one thing about this Ranger club. They have committed some errors this season. Ball right out there, his first error of the season. Just didn't look the ball into his glove. He was in position to make the play, then all of a sudden looked away from it. That's the 76th error of the season for the Rangers. Only the Oakland A's have more at 77.
So the Halos gifted a run courtesy of the error by Andy Chavez, which would have ended the second inning. And here's Jeff Mathis with two outs and Trout over at first. And Trout's got a pretty good lead at first base. Mathis showing bunt with two outs. Takes a strike and it's 0-1. Mathis had the night off last night. Bobby Wilson got the start behind the plate. Jeff went 0-2 in the first game of this series on Tuesday night. And the snowballs and two strikes.
And getting back to the fact is C.J. Wilson has allowed 15 stolen bases against him. High total for a left-handed pitcher.
Here's the 0-2 upstairs. One ball, two strikes.
Mike Trout was going back to the base there as C.J. Wilson was delivering the baseball. Young base stealer here, trying to get a read from a pitcher.
Mathis fouls that pitch back. So the count remains at a ball and two strikes. The Angels still looking for their first hit. They had a walk in the first. That was Ibarb. Howie Kendrick on an 0-2 pitch. Reached via the hit batsman. And Trout reaching on the error by Andy Chavez.
And that's one of those just show get over move. That might be his best move over to first base. So we haven't seen anything better yet.
Mathis goes down swinging. That will end the inning. The Angels get a run on no hits. There was an error and they leave a man on. Two of the books, 1-0 Angels. Error by Andy Chavez, and Chavez will lead things off here against Jared Weaver, 9-1 and 2 for Texas. Chavez, Kinsler, and Andrews. Chavez went 0-3 yesterday, hitting
339 on the season as he takes a breaking ball for his drive. Four home runs, 15 runs batted in. He's gotten the start in all three games out in center field. Craig Gentry is the other guy that gets some playing time out there. We saw him last night as a pinch runner in the ninth inning. A pitch outside. It's one ball, one strike. Weaver with a couple of strikeouts. One walk, two hits allowed. A double in the first to Andrews. A single to Moreland with two outs in the second. Misses down low.
Well, that pitch before, Jared, threw a 68-mile-an-hour curveball. He's throwing a 68-mile-an-hour curveball and a 92-mile-an-hour fastball so far.
This one popped up. Meister Stewart is backpedaling out, having to deal with the sunshine, makes the catch. And there's the first out here in the third. Fans on Tuesday, August the 2nd, the Angels take on the Minnesota Twins at 7:05. All fans in attendance will receive a 50th anniversary banner courtesy of Chevy. Purchase your tickets today by visiting the Angel Stadium ticket office or online at angels.com.
Well, I'll tell you what, Jared can get a lot of pop-ups in the infield when he gets swings out in front of either the slow curveball or changeup. A lot of pop-ups stay in the infield against him.
Here's Ian Kinsler, and he looks at a fastball for his track. Do you think the Minnesota missile known as Norm Peters, our statistician guru, is excited about the Minnesota Twins coming to town?
He almost pulled a hamstring jumping up and down because the Twins were coming into town.
That's what I thought. Kinsler fouls this one back, and it's no balls, two strikes. He decided to pull the old courtesy red shirt today.
It was good to see.
Which he allegedly said he went out and purchased. I don't know. I need to see a receipt. But the Minnesota Missile, because of his bowling game apparently, is how he got his nickname. 0-2 pitch. Kinsler takes one upstairs. One ball, two strikes.
So he's a good bowler, huh?
A great dancer, too. He's been spotlighted on the big screen here at the Big A for the peanut butter jelly can. A one ball, two strike count. And another 1-2. Kinsler lifts this one out toward right center field. Mike Trout curling around to his left, makes the catch, two outs. So Kinsler is 0-for-2, having popped down to his fears, and now the fly ball to Trout. Brings up Elvis Andrews.
Five fly ball outs so far against Jared, along with two strikeouts.
Matter of fact, Asturias has caught three of the pop-ups. Fastball up and away to Elvis. One ball, no strikes. Andrews chopped a double down to third baseline and then was thrown out trying to steal third base. This one lined to left field. It's a two-out base hit. Second consecutive inning in which that has occurred. Moreland got the knock in the second. So it keeps the inning alive for Josh Hamilton.
And that's been the formula for success for the Rangers. You know, able to come through with two-out base hits. Now Weave's mentality has to be to get through this inning, get Hamilton out here. Get the batters back to swinging against C.J. Wilson.
See the numbers for Josh Hamilton, day games versus night games. Splits last year not as big. As a matter of fact, very respectable 286 hitter during day games last year. And it came out he's having issues with his eyesight during the daytime. A lot of it having to do with the fact that he's got light colored eyes. At that light pigmentation, the sunshine provides too much of a glare, and it kind of gives someone with darker colored eyes a little bit more of an advantage to be able to filter out that sunlight. So he's tried contact lenses, now he's trying sunglasses to try to match what he's able to do during night games.
Yeah, sometimes, I mean, every hitter I've ever talked to, they've always preferred hitting during the day. You can see the baseball better generally.
This one grounded over to Ibarm. He'll flip it on to first. The inning comes to an end. No runs, one hit, one left. Down. We head to the bottom of the third, with the Angels still leading it 1-0.
Jay Wilson, who had two strikeouts in the second, but gave up an unearned run courtesy of the drop fly ball by Andy Chavez. Meiser grounded out in the first inning. He's 0 for 1 as Wilson delivers a breaking pitch in for strike one. The fastball clanking in and out of the glove of Mike Napoli. Misses outside. One ball, one strike. Meiser's hit well against left-handed pitching this year. 298 average. He bounces this one over to Beltre. He is retired for the first down. But the Stars overall has been scuffling over his last 11 games. Now 6 for his last 48.
And not really hitting the ball hard. Getting himself out of a number of those swings, whether it's out in front and rolling over on the ground ball from the right side and the left side. A lazy fly ball to left field, so he's got to keep his hands back a little bit better. Something we're certainly accustomed to seeing, hitting the ball on the line with his hands back and trusting it through the strike zone.
We'll bring up Ibar with one out, nobody on. Ibar working the only walk that Wilson has allowed in the first inning and was stranded there as that pitch is a strike. Delayed call by DJ Rayburn. Eric questioning the call. And it's no balls, two strikes as he went around on that breaking pitch. Texas with no runs, three hits, one error, three left. Don, the Angels, one run, no hits, no errors. And two men left on base.
Chavez made that error, his first error of the season. Tracked that baseball very well, but looked like he put his glove almost in front of his eyes and shielded himself as the ball hit his glove.
Count remains at no balls, two strikes. The Angels after the game jump on the birdhead across the country, take on the Baltimore Orioles for the first of three tomorrow night. 10-game road trip, three in Baltimore, three in Cleveland, four in Detroit. The Rangers end up going home. They take on the Toronto Blue Jays and Minnesota Twins. Ibar bounces one to the right side, Kinsler to his left. And there's the second out of the inning. Fans, on Thursday, August the 4th, the Angels wrap up their series against the Minnesota Twins at 7:05. All fans in attendance will receive a skater hat courtesy of Chronic Tacos. Purchase your tickets today at the Angel Stadium ticket office or at angels.com.
It's good luck. Can't wait for that hat, Victor. You can give it to me for my birthday.
There's the newsboy hat that we had earlier this year, the Minnesota Missiles favorite. And now we've got the skater hats. This one bounced up the middle. Kinsler's got it from behind the bag, and it's a 1-2-3 inning for C.J. Wilson. Three in the books. The Angels still with a 1-0 lead. 55, which four number one overall draft picks won a World Series title in the American League?
Darren Erstead's one of them.
Okay. I've got another one, but I'm not going to share it.
Thanks, man. I appreciate that.
You got it. Josh Hamilton, perhaps. Adrian Beltre takes outside. It's one ball, no strikes. Beltre, Young, Cruz. 4-5 and 6 for Texas here in the fourth. One ball, one strike. Beltre a strikeout victim to end the first inning. So it's over one. One of two punch outs for Weaver. 52 pitches thrown by Weave. 33 for strikes. And it's two balls and one strike. Jared coming off the win against the Oakland Athletics on the 16th. This one's fouled back. Count even a 2-2 now in that game against the A's. 6 2/3 innings, 7 hits allowed for Weaver. That was the first game of the doubleheader last Saturday. 2-2, got him swinging. Down goes Beltre, and there's out number one.
Boy, that was a great changeup, too, by Jared, who continues to throw a quality pitch to Adrian Beltre. Adrian is 9 for 51. We can see the grip right here. Staying on top. Circle change the way the baseball comes out. He's able to turn it over and takes away that speed, the grip itself. Way out in front. You could see how Beltre was so far out of that swing, unable to make contact. Well, that's such an effective pitch. We talked about it with Kurt McCaskill, that ability to throw a changeup. That was an excellent one there.
Michael Young driving one out toward right field. Vernon was playing deep. He'll track it down as he backpedals onto the track, and there are two outs.
Well, right here you can see the circle changeup. That's the pitch that's made Jared so effective. He will throw that to both the righties and lefties in a lot of times in fastball counts and back-to-back times. Well, the way the baseball just comes out of his hands, as a hitter, you think fastball, you're already starting your approach to the plate. The bat is way out in front as the baseball's traveling in and getting in the catcher's mitt, throwing off the timing.
Nelson Cruz at the plate with two outs. And he'll look at a fastball just off the plate. Cruz popped out. Meiser Asturias in the second inning, so he's 0 for 1. One ball, one strike. You know, whereas we just saw Hamilton wearing some glasses to kind of cut out the glare, it looks like Cruz is wearing those orange or shooting type glasses to make it a little bit brighter. Able to separate the colors. I never, as a fan, just a guy who plays a lot of golf, never liked those. It just made it almost too bright.
Yeah, you would think it'd be less time to be able to react. You don't have much time to begin with to react to try to hit a baseball.
Just missed outside. It's 2-2. There's Hamilton. This one's fouled back. And the Diamond Club. The count remains at 2-2.
I wonder if they'll go up the ladder here with a four-seam fastball now.
He did, and he tomahawks this one into right field. A two-out base hit for Nelson Cruz. That's a third straight inning that the Rangers have gotten a base knock with two outs.
Well, that's just you got to tip your hat to Nelson Cruz there to be able to get a base hit on that fastball that was up. Especially after some off-speed pitches prior to that. You think that's a good idea to try to elevate it. Cruz just went up with his hands and was able to hit that ball in the right field.
Here's Mitch Moreland, who had a base hit to left field with two outs in the second. Cruz will run on occasion, five stolen bases. He's been caught four times. Time is called as Moreland backs out. Moreland had a 1-for-4 game last night, picking up his 13th double. Fastball missing just off the plate. It's the third start for Weave against Texas. On April the 20th, picked up the victory. Fifth career complete game, striking out 8. Allowing 2 earned runs as that pitch is down low. And then on May the 13th, ended up taking the loss, allowing 4 earned runs in his 6 innings. Gave up 2 home runs in that game. Two to Moreland. Outside, 3-0.
Boy, Moreland's had some success against Jared. 5-for-15. But I've noticed in these 15 at-bats, he does a good job as far as laying off the changeup. Reads it well. The pitch just before that was a pretty good changeup. It was a little bit down below the zone, but a lot of hitters, especially left-handed hitters, will swing at that pitch from a right-handed pitcher. But he tracked that very well and let it go.
Which is the pitch we've seen Moreland get himself out on in the first 2 games of the series. Takes a strike. That's 3-1. Kind of out and reaching for it, rolling it over to the right side of the infield. But like you pointed out, still able to read Weaver better than the other guys. Not a very big lead for Cruz. A 3-1 pitch catches the inside corner. It's a full count. Cruz now will take off of the pitch. Trumbo will move back behind Nelson Cruz, especially the left-handed batter at the plate. There goes Cruz, a 3-2. It's cut on and missed. Down goes Moreland. And the inning comes to an end. We head to the bottom of the fourth with the Angels still with a 1-0 lead. Chicken sandwich combo is back for only $3.99 plus tax at participating restaurants. Halos on top by the score of 1-0 as we start the bottom of the fourth inning. The Angels still looking for their first hit against C.J. Wilson. They're trying to get it here in the fourth. Vernon Wells, Alberto Callaspo, and Howie Kendrick due up. It's 4, 5, and 6. Wells grounded out to Elvis Andrews to end the first inning. As he shoots this one towards second, and Ian Kinsler's got the liner. And there's the first out of the fourth. Let's go back to our AT&T trivia question. Since 1965, which four number one overall draft picks won a World Series title in the American League? Mike Moore, Daryl Strawberry, Darren Erstead, Alex Rodriguez.
Wow, Mike Moore had a really hard sinking fastball, nasty slider himself when he came up with Seattle. Hamilton almost.
Almost. You're paying attention, big guy. This one down the right field line. It slices foul.
He wasn't fortunate enough to get that World Series winning ring.
So I'm going to start doing that from now on just to keep you on your toes. See if you're paying attention to what I'm actually saying. Is it just supposed to just nodding at me all the time?
You say something?
Mm-hmm. 0-2 to Callaspo, and he lifts one in the air down the line. Nelson Cruz coming on. 2 outs. Two very relatively easy outs for C.J. Wilson here, who's retired 6 in a row since that error by Andy Chavez allowed the Angels to score the one and only run in this game. Hamilton, by the way, the first overall in 99 by the
Tampa Bay Devil Rays.
Devil Rays at that time. That's how he swings through that one. It's no balls and one strike. Oh, one pitch. No balls, two strikes. Howie hit by a pitch and scored the run in the second. Let's see if I could stump you with a little Josh Hamilton trivia.
All right.
Upstairs, one ball, two strikes. Which team had the rights to Josh Hamilton immediately prior to the Cincinnati Reds?
I was going to go with, as soon as you put Cincinnati in there, you threw me off.
Howie takes
a
call,
strike
three. Yeah, you can think about it.
Yes.
A 1-2-3 inning for C.J. Wilson. 4 in the books, 1-0 Angels. A baseball game, take in a baseball game as well.
So far, so good.
1-0 Angels here in the top of the fifth inning. Mike Napoli to lead things off, followed by Andy Chavez, then Ian Kinsler. 8-9-1 for Texas. As Kinsler hits one high in the air down a left field line. Kiaspo and Ibar. Ibar calls off Alberto. One pitch, one out to start this fifth inning.
Well, much easier play for Ibar coming across because there's a third baseman going back. You're right, looking right into the glare of the sun. Is it, and angle's better for Ibar from that shortstop position. Came in and make that play.
So that'll bring up Chavez, the center fielder, with one out here in the third. All right, you've had, how many minutes have you had to think about this Josh Hamblin? Which team owned the rights to him prior to the Cincinnati Reds? So he went from the Tampa Bay Rays, Devil Rays, to
the Pittsburgh Pirates.
No, but that's a good guess. It was a Rule 5 pick by the Chicago Cubs in order to flip him to the Cincinnati Reds.
Another good move by Chicago.
Yeah, Cubs couldn't use Josh Hamblin.
Because that's a huge ballpark, and the ball doesn't carry there at all.
Guess who they got for him? Chavez takes down low. It's one ball, or two balls and no strikes. Cash considerations.
That's not Dave Cash, the guy who used to play second base?
No. Hamblin made his return. Obviously, nobody knew what he was capable of doing after spending so much time away from the game. Cincinnati traded him to Texas. Edits at Volquez. Part of that package going to Cincinnati. And a trade that I think, obviously, it's kind of leaned more towards Texas. He won American League Most Valuable Player Award. But Edinson Volquez is a pretty good starting pitcher.
Yeah, he's got great stuff.
He's scuffled of late, but, I mean, he's a pretty good starting pitcher.
Yeah, with his health. But, I mean, he does have number one quality type stuff in a rotation. But I think Cincinnati was a little leery of Hamblin wearing down that 1 year for him. He was very good and wore down a little bit towards the end of the season trying to stay healthy.
Chavez waving at the off-speed pitch. And there are two outs. Strikeout number 5 for Jared Weaver.
Well, Jared has that changeup working today. The last few games, although, his numbers have been fantastic. It really has been his fastball and his slider and curve. But his changeup today has been unbelievable.
So with two outs and nobody on, Ian Kinsler steps up. Jared still looking for his first 1-2-3 inning. Kinsler 0 for 2, a couple of fly ball outs. Looks at a strike on the inside corner.
One thing too good about Jared is when he goes inside on a right-handed batter with a fastball, he'll generally back it up with another fastball inside like he did.
Goes back outside, and it's two balls and a strike. 77 pitches thrown by Weaver here in the fifth with two outs. 48 strikes, 29 balls. One walk and those five punch outs. 2-2.
A little cut fastball, great location, that pitch at 89 miles an hour.
Oh, Jose Tolentino with the catch. Spanish TV broadcast. Pretty good catch.
No problem making that play.
Another 2-2. Change up. This is down low. Full count now with Elvis Andrews on deck.
He has to protect a famous man in the booth with him.
You're absolutely right. 3-2 and hit in the air toward left. Howie Kendrick comes in. Weaver has his first 1-2-3 inning. We head to the bottom of the fifth inning with the Angels leading to get 1-0.
Trumbo, Trout, and Mathis here against the left-hander. Wilson with three strikeouts and one walk as Trumbo pulls one down the left field line. It is hooking into this foul. Out in front of that breaking pitch.
Well, he throws that slow curveball on the outer half of the plate very effectively, and it gets the right-handers out in front, and Trumbo just pulls that ball foul. C.J. Wilson, the guy, again, he throws the fastball away, changeup away, but also throws his curveball on the outer half. That's why you see a lot of ground balls, weak ground balls, to the right side against him.
A ball on the strike on Mark. It was a strikeout victim in the second. That strikeout came with a wild pitch. That's what allowed Howie Kendrick to get into scoring position. And Howie eventually scoring as Mike Trout, the next batter, ended up in the fly ball. It seemed routine enough for the alley in right center field. And Chavez just had it go off his glove.
Well, you think right now, if they're back-to-back sliders down and in, they're going to try to throw that fastball away. Trumbo has real good power to right center field.
2-1 pitch. Fastball. That's a base hit into right field. A clean single between first and second. And Trumbo's on board as a leadoff man with a base hit.
Well, that's that right approach. He knew that pitch was coming on the outer half of the plate after back-to-back sliders. Kept his hands back and shot that ground ball. A pretty good pitch. Stayed back and drove that ball very well to right field for a base hit.
First time this afternoon, the Angels have had their leadoff man on board. Mike Trout will step to the plate. The Rangers play Trout shallow in the outfield, especially in center and right, playing in the opposite way. Fastball is in there for strike one. Mike has one extra base hit in the big leagues. It was a double. Two runs batted in.
Boy, Hamilton is way off the left field line.
Lifted in the air to shallow center. Chavez comes on. This time with two hands, makes the catch for the first out. Trumbo remains at first. So one out, one on. Here comes Jeff Mathis, the catcher. Mathis, a strikeout victim his last time up. So he's 0 for 1. Quick throw to first. Trumbo is back. Would not surprise me to see Trumbo go at some point. 8 stolen bases for the big man. He caught 4 times.
That's Mike Socha. Likes to put the hit and run on with Jeff Mathis. That way it allows him to shorten up his swing and just look to make contact.
Pitch just missed in. That's one ball, no strikes. This one fouled back. One ball, one strike. Dino Ebo flashing the signs. A quick throw over, and Trumbo's back easily. Wilson last year, a breakout season for him as a starter, 33 starts. As Mathis pulls him foul, it's 1-2. 15-8, a 3.35 earned run average. Southern California native makes his home in Newport.
fifth round pick by Texas in 2001 and a free agent to be. One-two pitch. Mathis goes down swinging, two outs. Hey, folks, this week on Fox Saturday Baseball, the Padres head to Philadelphia to take on Ryan Howard and the National League East leading Philadelphia Phillies. This week's telecast on Fox Saturday Baseball begins at 1 p.m. Pacific, only on Fox. Strikeout of Jeff Mathis, the fourth for C.J. Wilson. Meiser Stouris will step to the plate with two outs, and Trumbo still standing at first. Meiser 0 for 2, a couple of ground outs, takes that pitch inside. This will bounce right back toward the middle. Wilson knocks it down, and Stouris is retired for the third out here in the fifth. Five of the books. The Angels still lead it 1-0.
Field. That quick speed, great first step. Jerry Weaver says, great job out there making that play defensively. That was our Coors Light freeze can brought to you by Frost Brew Coors Light.
Halos up 1-0. Elvis Andrews, Josh Hamilton, Adrian Beltre here against Jared Weaver in the sixth inning. The curveball is in for a strike. Andrews 2-for-2 against Weaver. The chop double down to third base line and a base hit with two outs in the third. Pulls this one and backhanded by Alberto Callaspo on one hop. Spins around and fires to first. There's out number one.
Nice job playing in to try to take away that bunt. Short one hop, that reactionary position to third base. Strong throw to get that lead batter of the inning. Had it no problem on the backhand for Callaspo.
There's Josh Hamilton with one out. Pulls first pitch to the right side. Trumbo backhands a little underhanded flip. Two away.
Let's take a look at our Jaguar performance. Jared Weaver so far in this ballgame has had an outstanding changeup, throwing a ton of strikes. Boy, fastball by Beltre. Napoli cannot hit the fastball. Great changeup there. And elevates the fastball to Moreland. They finish off the inning at Chavez with that great changeup. Five punch outs so far with two outs here in the sixth inning for Jared Weaver leading 1-0.
Facing Adrian Beltre, who has struck out twice against him this afternoon, lays off the breaking pitch.
Jared with five punch outs, one walk. The four hits allowed, solo hits for the Rangers through the first four innings, one each in those first four. Just missed off the plate, two balls and no strikes. Good location with that fastball. A 2-1 count. Belcher's had a pretty good series against the Angels. A 2-for-5 game on Tuesday. 2-for-4 last night. A couple of doubles. Three runs batted in. The breaking pitch. He's in there. Full count.
Belcher just still trying to guess along with Jared to determine which pitch he's going to throw. A lot of times he's assuming a fastball is coming, but Jared's been able to either throw a curveball or a changeup in those predictable counts.
Breaking pitch shot into the right field corner, and this one's going to go for extra bases. Off the wall, Vernon gets the baseball back in, and Beltre will stop at second with a two-out double.
We had to strike out the first two at bats, went with the pitch. Another breaking pitch on the outer half. Just high enough, about thigh high outside to be able to drive that ball to right field. Now it is 10-for-52 in his career against Jared Weaver.
28th double of the year. 425th of his career. Mike Butcher, quick visit to the mound just to talk things over with Michael Young coming to the plate.
Michael Young has some success against Jared, so you might think in terms of not necessarily walking him, but making him swing at your pitch out of the strike zone, see if he can get himself out.
Young this afternoon is in a fly ball to center field and a fly ball to right. He's 0-for-2. Vernon playing very deep in right field with Beltre at scoring position. Fastball misses outside.
So two baseballs pretty well that way. One, so Mike Trout was able to track down and dive and make the play. And the next time up, hit a pretty deep fly ball to Vernon Wells and right.
Two balls and no strikes. Now Mathis going out there.
The thing about a pitcher like Jared Weaver, not only you have good stuff, but you're smart on the mound too. You know a guy up there that's hit the ball well against you, that's pretty decent numbers in his career. Although Nelson Cruz does have a base hit in this game, he hasn't really had a lot of success against Jared. Make him hit your pitch, make him swing at something out of the strike zone.
Three balls, no strikes. There's Nelson Cruz. 1-for-2 game so far for him. And he walks him. Second of the ball game for Weaver. Now runners at first and second with two outs. Nelson Cruz stepping to the plate. The one for Cruz, a base hit with two outs in the fourth inning. Punching one into right field. Adrian Belcher is the man at second. He had the two out double. Young's over at first. It's Cruz. It's that one off the end of the bat. No balls at the strike.
Boy, great pitch. When you think about it, you're a hitter coming up there. You just see a pitcher walk a batter on four pitches. You think he's going to try to sneak a fastball by first pitch. Instead, threw a great changeup to him.
Oh, and two.
Getting underneath the hands with a fastball.
A glance back to Beltre. Here comes the 0-2. Missed inside with a fastball. Backed it up again. One ball, two strike count.
Still a good purpose pitch. Sometimes you'll get a hitter to the swing at that baseball, especially after you just hit the inside corner with the pitch before.
Off speed, foul back. Had him lunging.
Boy, that was a good changeup again. Well, he's throwing a 94-mile-an-hour fastball and a 68-mile-an-hour changeup. His curveball has been around 68, 69. He's done such a good job as far as differential and in speeds of his pitches.
Bounces this one foul, coming back inside with the fastball. So the count remains at a ball and two strikes. Weaver getting ready to throw his 100th pitch of the game.
Well, that's surprising.
Yeah.
I wasn't even thinking in terms of pitch count because he's been throwing the ball very well, but there's been some foul baseballs, but that's about it. Two walks, but that last walk was basically an intentional pitch out of the strike zone to see if he get on the swing with an open base.
Well, he overthrows the breaking pitch. Count even now 2-2. Pitch you want to get him on. Runners at first and second. So that you don't force the 3-2. Two outs getting the runners off of the pitch. This one chopped over to third. Cayasso backs up on it. Has to throw across the diamond. And Cruz is going to leg it out. Infield base hit. The minute Cayasso backed up on that baseball, the minute you realize that Cruz, who's got pretty decent speed for a big man, is able to leg down one out, so they're loaded up.
Yeah, originally coming in on that baseball. Got a strong arm, but Cruz runs very well. We'll leg that out for an infield base hit.
So Mitch Moreland will step up with the bases loaded. Beltre at third, Young at second, and Cruz over at first. Moreland swinging through a fastball there. No balls and one strike. Moreland had a base hit in the second inning, struck out in the fourth.
No matter how well you're going on the mound, there's always going to be an inning in which the game is going to be in the balance. And this is certainly the case here for Jared, who has outstanding stuff and has been throwing the ball very well also.
Down and in. One ball, one strike. Jared working from the stretch here. Swing and a miss on a changeup. One ball, two strikes.
He did a good job selling this. Finally, he got Moreland to swing at this changeup down and out of the strike zone. Great arm action on that pitch.
One, two on its way. Moreland fouls it back. Coming inside with the fastball.
Look at that no-seam fastball against him. It ran over the middle of the plate. He had a pretty good swing at it, and he's had some good swings. 313 career batting average, including two big flies against Jared. Wonder if he would go now four-seam fastball in on his hands.
This one fouled back. Count remains at 1-2. That was the 25th pitch thrown by Weaver in this inning. It started with a two-out double by Adrian Beltre. Down in the dirt. Blocked by Mathis, 2-2.
Yeah, Weaver got Andrews to ground out to third, got Hamilton to ground out to first. Beltre doubled into the right field corner. Michael Young, the four-pitch walk to face Nelson Cruz, and Cruz got the infield base hit. And now the 2-2 pitch. Moreland strikes out swinging. Down he goes. And the Rangers leave him loaded. No runs, two hits, three left on base. Jared Weaver picks up his sixth strikeout as the Angels maintain a 1-0 lead.
Get your game on by El Pollo Loco. Try El Pollo Loco's two-piece leg and thigh combo with two small classic sides and a drink for $5. El Pollo Loco, feel the excellence. And by Time Warner Cable.
Halo's still with a 1-0 lead as we start the bottom of the sixth inning. Jared Weaver at the top of the inning with the bases loaded. Weave obviously very pumped up getting that strikeout, and so are the guys in that dugout.
Tell you what, I like that out of Jared Weaver, the emotions he has every time he takes that mound. And a lot of times you think leaders of ball clubs, it's generally going to be an everyday player because a pitcher goes out every 5 days, but that type of emotion allows Jared Weaver to be a leader on this club.
Eric Ibar leads things off here, followed by Torrey Hunter, then Vernon Wells. 2-3 and 4 for the Angels. Ibar 0 for 1 with a walk in the first inning, a ground out in the third. In tight. It's two balls and no strikes. This one foul back, 2-1 now. Ibar trying to push button, hits it too hard. Moreland will easily tag him out, one away.
Boy, great idea. If it gets it towards Ian Kinsler, he's going to beat that baseball out. And C.J. Wilson, at times, is not as far as making, you know, good throws to first base. A lot of times the clubs try to force him to field bunts, make him field his position. He'll throw that ball away on occasion to first base. The right idea, but just didn't quite get that bunt where he wanted to for Eric Ibar.
Torrey Hunter steps up, looks at a fastball away. Torrey's 0 for 2 with a pop-up and a ground out. One hit allowed by C.J. Wilson. That was a leadoff single to Mark Trumbo in the fifth. Torrey fouls one off to the right. 1-2 count now. Mentioned the Angels taking on the Baltimore Orioles at Camden beginning tomorrow night. Irvin Santana will be going up against Alfredo Simon. Pinheiro on Saturday, Tyler Chatwood on Sundays. That pitch is down and in. Simon will be followed by Brad Bergeson, then Jeremy Guthrie.
Well, Guthrie's had a tough time this year. Always felt he had real good stuff. He hasn't consistently thrown enough strikes.
Torrey goes down swinging, two outs. Kids on Sunday, August the 7th, SpongeBob and Dora the Explorer will be at the Big A when the Angels host the Seattle Mariners. That's a 12:35 start. All kids 2 to 18 will receive a SpongeBob shirt courtesy of Nickelodeon. Purchase your tickets at the Angels Stadium ticket office or at angels.com.
Can I get one of those shirts?
Weren't you wearing one in Oakland?
Oh, yeah.
The San Francisco area?
SpongeBob and Patrick, Sandy.
See, I don't want SpongeBob.
No?
Dora, yeah. One ball, no strikes here on Vernon. Wells 0-2. The ground ball to short. The line out to Kinsler, second base.
You can see the SpongeBob SquarePants movie with David Hasselhoff in there making a special appearance.
No. The Hoff was there, huh?
Yep. Well, you missed out.
I guess it just depends on your opinion.
You don't like the Knight Rider?
I like Knight Rider.
Yeah.
When I was 12. 1-1 pitch. I mean, that was in your glory days, your early 30s when Knight Rider was on.
I did have the Knight Rider ride, too, by the way.
You had a big Firebird, didn't you?
Yes, I did.
With the Firebird.
Yes, I had the black head cut, on my tires and everything else. It was a beautiful ride, believe it or not.
Three balls and a strike on Vernon Wells with two outs here in the sixth inning. This one bounced foul just wide of the bag at third. And the full count. You really have not seen, credit T.J. Wilson for this, but you really have not seen a lot of comfortable swings.
It is two full counts against CJ. Bottom line is you like to prolong this inning if you can. It's a tough battle for Jared to get through that last inning. Give him a little bit of a breather.
And Wells goes down swinging. Another 1-2-3 inning for CJ Wilson. Six complete. The Angels still with a 1-0 lead. Top of the seventh, Jared Weaver and the Angels with a 1-0 lead, one unearned run. A drop fly ball by Andy Chavez that allowed Howie Kendrick to score in the second. It's been the only scoring. Jared Weaver coming off a taxing sixth inning. And the bases loaded but struck out Moreland. Here's Mike Napoli to lead things off. At first pitch swinging and leaping up is Alberto Callazco and robbing Napoli of extra bases, one out.
What a great reaction by Callazco, who's made a couple very good plays in this game. Well, in position, ready to go, leaps up on that rocket by Mike Napoli. Get the first out on one pitch.
It's mad hops right there for Callazco.
Quick as a cat.
So one out, nobody on for Andy Chavez, the center fielder. Chavez has popped out to Asturias. That was leading off the third inning, a strikeout victim in the fifth.
Well, in games like this, when you have two aces on the hill, you rely so much on your defense, but the bottom line is when you're throwing a lot of strikes, you're going to be on your toes to make those type of plays. So if you're a young pitcher, say like a Tyler Chatwood, just realize the defense can make those plays for you.
Popped up near the dugout. Mark Trumbo is there. Two outs. Four pitches here in the seventh for Jared. 112 the total.
Mike Socha may give him an opportunity to go back out to the eighth if he has a quick at bat here against Kinsler. Get him out on one or two pitches. Might give him that shot in the eighth inning to shorten up the amount of outs he'll have to get out of the bullpen today.
Kinsler takes down low. The Ranger second baseman 0 for 3. Three fly ball outs, one to second, one to center, one to left. This one fouled back to the right. One ball, one strike. In case you're wondering, Scott Downs, who worked a very quick first inning, even though he went two frames yesterday. The last night, threw 19 pitches in his two innings, with one strikeout. Two balls and a strike. Whoever it is in the eighth will be dealing with the middle part of the order. It's a 2-1 pitch. It's just a little bit high. Three balls and one strike. Elvis Andrews, the shortstop, on deck. Fastball right down the middle. And the count has gone full. Most pitches thrown by Weaver in a game this year, 128. He's done that a couple of times in Minnesota and in Seattle. There's a 3-2. Kinsler drives one out toward left field. Howie Kendrick is back there. And it's a 1-2-3 inning for Weaver. Seventh inning stretch time here at the Big A. The Angels still with a 1-0 lead.
Well, Ryan said pitch on Friday night. Let's get tickets for Friday night because he could throw a no-hitter. He was the meal ticket, if there was such a thing.
Nolan Ryan, we wish him the very best as he gets back to 100%, spending some time in the hospital. Unable to attend the Gene Autry induction ceremony, but send his well wishes and hopes to be out here the last series of the year. The Rangers finish up the regular season here at the Big A. 10 more games between these two teams after today. 7 here, 3 back in Arlington. Callazo swinging first pitch against C.J. Wilson, pulls one foul. That's no balls and a strike.
Well, and every time I, you know, when he was with Texas and we faced him over the years, you just assume he had a chance at a no-hitter, Nolan Ryan. He had that type of stuff. Even as he progressed, he was even in his 40s. An amazing pitcher.
There's the 1-1 pitch. Callazo fouls it back. 1-2. Alberto 0 for 2 with a ground ball to third and a fly ball to right. 6 strikeouts for C.J. Wilson. 1 walk. 1 hit. This one bounced foul up the third base side. I know we touched on a little bit as Wilson had a very quick sixth inning, striking out 2 batters there. But he really, the guy who has been known at times to be a nibbler, working really just on the outside corner. He's worked both sides of the plate well this afternoon. As this one's heading toward the dugout.
He's had a pretty good feel for both his curveball and slider today.
This being his third start, he's fared well already this season, his first 2 starts. Callazo fouls this one off again toward the dugout. Moreland coming over near the railing and runs out of room.
Boy, again, he's going to be a free agent, too, that, you know, he hasn't been taxed a whole lot as far as number of pitches thrown as a starter. A lot of work out of the bullpen, so you would think he's going to be a guy that a number of teams are going to be interested in.
You would think he's at or at around the top of the list there. I guess all depends on what C.C. Sabathia decides to do. As Callazo goes down swinging for the first out, Sabathia could opt out and get free agency.
You would think it's that Sabathia would just opt out and then resign.
Yep.
This is one of the important part of the ball game for the offensive side, to get that little insurance run or two. Especially with that middle part of the lineup coming up now, the next inning for the Rangers.
Howie Kendrick with a 1-ball, no strike count. Howie's been hit by a pitch and he has struck out. Scott Downs starting to stretch now in the bullpen. So
that tells me more than likely Weaver's going to get Andrews, and then Scott Downs right. Will go in to face Hamilton.
Two balls and a strike now on Howie Kendrick. Wilson struck out 3 consecutive hitters, Hunter and Wells to finish the 6th. Callazo to start the 7th. Howie pops one up to shallow right field. Nelson Cruz coming on, dives and makes the catch. Terrific play by Cruz at the last minute, leaving his feet. There are 2 outs.
Boy, he read that baseball well. Not hit hard by Howie, but he's able to charge it in. Reed dives, makes that play. Too often you see a right fielder dive face first to be able to make a play like that, but he's able to do so. There's been some great defensive plays, although granted the Angels scored 1 run and the only run of the game on a bad defensive play. But other than that, it's been a very solid effort by everybody on both sides, on the defensive side.
Trumbo looks at a fastball down low. Mark is the owner of the only Angels hit today. It was a leadoff single in the fifth inning. Two balls and no strikes. Texas with no runs, six hits, an error. They've left seven on. The Angels with one run, one hit, no errors, three left on base.
Well, a good hitter's count now for Trumbo is to be the 89th pitch from C.J. Wilson. Most times he's going to go away, but at times when you get up there as far as the pitch count, you make a mistake and leave the ball middle part of the plate. But Trumbo is going to be looking for something in that area, then let it go.
Takes a strike. It's 2-1. That pitch on the outer third of the plate, not one of those you want to take a chance on if you're going to let it fly. Here's a 2-1. Foul back. The Halos snapping the Rangers' 12-game winning streak last night, but they're come from behind victory. Picking up a game on Texas. Got him swinging a high fastball, and it's a 1-2-3 inning yet again for C.J. Wilson. Seven of the books, the Angels still, though, with a 1-0 lead. A look at our Farmers Insurance report card.
Boy, Jerry, we were seven shutout innings. ERA barely over one in his last seven starts. C.J. Wilson, very good himself. No earned runs in seven innings. And the Angels, that 21-10 mark since June 13th. It's the best in Major League Baseball.
Weaver back out there to face Elvis Andrews. He takes a curveball for his strike. Andrews, Hamilton, and Beltre here in the eighth for Texas. Elvis, 2-for-3, a double, a single. And a ground out in the sixth. Showing bunt takes that pitch.
Boy, that was a pretty good pitch.
It's right down the middle. One ball, one strike. Like perhaps the action of Andrews not allowing DJ Rayburn to see that pitch. 1-1. Two balls and a strike. Down, still playing catch. Should be ready to go if needed. This one grounded toward the middle. Ibar can't get it. It's a leadoff base hit. Mike Socha coming up the steps. That looks like it's going to be it for Jared. And Weaver visibly upset at the non-call by DJ Rayburn, which changed the complexion of the at-bat. Instead of 0-2, it went to 1-1. ends up giving up the leadoff base hit. No question getting a terrific round of applause here by Andrews Kingston. Scott Downs coming into the game. And the Angels on top, 1-0.
Where you can get your PCM on. Text MOJO to 99000 to win a large PCM. Shakey's World's Greatest Pizza, Crispy Fried Chicken, and famous MOJO Potatoes. Go to Shakey's.com for more information. And by Chase. Deposit checks from your smartphone with Quick Deposit. Take a step forward and chase what matters.
Nobody out and a man at first base here in the top of the eighth inning. Josh Hamilton at the plate, and our in and out, who's in, who's out. Scott Downs takes over for Jared Weaver. Pitched last night through two innings. Struck out a man, and everything else was zeros. Got to be cognizant of Elvis Andrews over at first base, 28 stolen bases. He's been caught now five times. He's thrown out at third base in the first inning by Jeff Mathis. Josh Hamilton has drawn a walk, and he's grounded out twice. He's 0 for 2. Here's the 1-0 pitch. Swing and a miss in the breaking ball. And it's one ball, one strike.
What a good spike. Way out in front, 74 mile an hour breaking pitch. After missing away on the first one.
Downs did not face Hamilton, Beltre, or Young last night in his two innings of relief. Andrews over at first base, the responsibility, property of Jared Weaver. Allowed seven hits this afternoon. 1-1. Swing and a miss in the breaking pitch. One ball, two strikes. Weaver with six strikeouts and two walks in his seven-plus innings. One, two, grounded to the right side, backhanded by Trumbull. They go to second, they get the lead runner. And there's out number one. Hamilton reaching on the fielder's choice.
Well, obviously, your bottom line is to get that lead runner, especially a guy with that type of speed. Although Hamilton runs well, not in the same category as Andrews at first. Still put yourself in position to get a double play and get through the inning. Adrian Beltre has hit into 11 double plays.
Hamilton has five stolen bases this year. He's been caught stealing once. Trumbo playing just in front of him at first base. Adrian Beltre, a 1-for-3 game, had a double in the sixth inning. Swings and lifts one in the air toward right center field. Long run for Mike Trout. Calls off for it. Wells, he'll make the catch for the second out as Hamilton heads back to first. That ball just continued to carry, and we've talked about it. Anytime there's a day game here, ball will carry well to all parts of the field. Nice job by Trout to track it down.
I didn't think he'd necessarily crush that ball, but it just kept carrying, and Trout had to go a long, long way. Good communication, calls off Vernon Wells, gets himself in position. See right there, he's saying he's got it. The center fielder is the quarterback of that outfield position. Good play by Trout.
Michael Young steps up. Hamilton still at first with two outs. Young 0 for 2. Did draw a walk in the sixth inning. Touch down in the dirt. One ball, no strikes. Jordan Walden begins to play catch in the Angels' pen. Young taps this one foul. It's one ball, one strike. Walden, just like Downs last night, threw 19 pitches. Walden did it in his one inning of relief, picking up his 22nd save. The 1-1. This one out towards center field. Might hang up for Trout. It will. That will end the eighth inning. No runs. A leadoff single and one man left on base. We head to the bottom of the eighth with the Angels still on top. As of yet today, but the Angels do have a 1-0 lead here in the bottom of the eighth inning. Mike Trout, Jeff Mathis, Meister Asturias, 8-9-1 against C.J. Wilson. There's 8 strikeouts. Trout takes the breaking ball for a strike. One walk by Wilson, that was in the first. One hit batter, one hit allowed. Trout is 0 for 2. That pitch nearly hit him. It's one ball, one strike. Got it. Trout pulling one down the line, but foul. It's one ball, two strikes. You know, with each passing game, you see a 19-year-old kid in the batter's box feeling more and more comfortable at the plate.
Starting to read pitches, trying to find out a tendency of a pitcher against him. The minor leagues are just basically reacting to a fastball.
Flips this one down to right field line. Nelson Cruz will watch this one bounce in front of him in foul territory. And I'm not saying that just to say that, all right, Mike Trout's ready, he should be the everyday center fielder. I'm just saying a guy who's been up in the big leagues for a week and a half at such a young age. You've seen big strides from the first couple of weeks, the first couple of games, where there's no question nerves played a huge role in his early struggles. The guy that seems like, all right, I get it. That's the biggest thing. I get it. I can play at this level.
Exactly. And I can hit. I just got to hit pitches that I'm accustomed to swinging at. I'm not going to swing at a pitcher's pitch. That's the difference between the minor leagues and the major leagues. Pitchers in the major leagues won't throw that fastball right down the middle all the time. They're going to throw a changeup in a fastball count. They're going to throw a curveball. In the minor leagues, you struggle to throw your off-speed pitch for a strike, so you're generally going to throw that only when you're ahead.
Two balls, two strikes now. Peter Borges, if everything continues to progress well for his strained hamstring, he's eligible to come off the disabled list Saturday. This one bounced over to short. Andrews has it. And learning from last night, got rid of it quickly and retires Trout for the first out. Well, I mentioned this, E.J. Wilson has allowed just one hit today. The game is the leadoff man, Mark Trumbo, started the fifth by punching one through the right side. A very clean single. But Trumbo ended up staying stranded at first base.
Well, Wilson's been outstanding. When you look up again, Jerry Weaver, no runs allowed again.
Seven plus innings.
Amazing.
Mathis fouls off the first pitch.
What a gutsy performance by Scott Downs, too. After two innings pitched last night, comes right back and shuts down that middle part of their lineup.
Jared Weaver, by the way, dropped his ERA from 1.90 to 1.81 for the seven-inning performance today.
And today's date is July 21st, right? Mm-hmm. Let's check it. That's an amazing.
Yep.
And that's in the American League. Generally, it's about a half a run differential between ERAs in the American League and National League.
Two balls and a strike on Mathis. ...100 pitches just now thrown by C.J. Wilson. That's how effective he has been. Looks like he went with a changeup there.
Didn't follow through on his delivery either. Just tried to aim that pitch. And Mathis, good fastball count. This is a time where you got to think extra base hit if you're Jeff Mathis. Try to get a fastball in or half.
3-1. Mathis chasing the pitch down and away from him. Fly. Pops a foul on the first base side. Full count now.
That's a hitter when you're struggling. You swing at a pitch like that. 3-1, you know you're getting a fastball. You expanded your strike zone against a guy who's been throwing the ball well. Probably ball four.
Mathis pops it up. Elvis Andrews, the shortstop, calling for it. There are two outs. So with two outs, the base is clear. Back to the top of the order. Meiser Stur is coming up. Meiser 0 for his last 0 for 3 today. Scuffling for a while now. Six for his last 49. For his last 10. He had a first inning single in Sunday's game against Gio Gonzalez. 0-1 pitch. Missed down low. One ball, one strike. In the ninth, Texas has Cruz, Moreland, and Napoli, the Schedule 3 guys. George Walden will be coming on looking for his 23rd save as Meister pulls one just inside the bag. That's going for extra bases. Forget about that Oford. It's a two-out double for Asturias, his 21st of the year.
Well, maybe that's the type of a bat that gets Meister going. It's been a struggle. Mislocation with that fastball. He's able to turn on and hit it right down the third base line by Beltre, which has not been easy in this series to get anything by him.
Mark Lowe, the right-hander, begins to loosen. Ibar swinging at that first pitch, comes up empty. One ball, one strike. Ibar today 0 for 2. That includes a walk. It's two balls and a strike.
Pretty good arms in the outfield for the Rangers, so it's going to be important for Meister to get that good jump, good secondary lead. Derek Ibar gets a base hit into the outfield. Dino Riba will not hesitate to challenge these arms, in particular with Cruz and Wright. Very good arm. It takes a while to get rid of it. Hamilton, very accurate. Chavez in center, very good, too.
That one's rolled foul just in front of Dino. Two balls, two strikes. Asturias over at second base with two outs here in the eighth. Ibar chopping one to short. Andrews comes charging in. Gets rid of it quickly, and that will end the inning. The Angels leave a man in scoring position. We've played eight. Here comes Waldo. We're headed to the ninth with the Angels up 1-0. To take two of three from the Texas Rangers to pick up another game as Mike Scioscia turns the ball over to Jordan Walden, as we mentioned, through 19 pitches last night. picked up his 22nd save of the season, tying Angels' rookie record. And here in the ninth, he'll be facing Cruz, Moreland, and Napoli.
Moreland, again, that command of the fastball just to keep that adrenaline intact. Trying to overthrow pitches. His slider has been very good of late also, especially with a couple right-handed batters. Opportunity to be able to use that pitch.
Nelson Cruz today, 2-for-3, a couple of singles. Takes a breaking pitch down and away. It was Cruz who struck out to end the game last night. Fastball is in there for a strike. Two balls and one strike. Two one. Upstairs. Falling behind here. Three balls and a strike. Left hand hitting Mitch Moreland on deck. Scott Downs, by the way, went one inning. All zeros for him. Full count.
Still good life in that fastball. 3-1 at 96 miles an hour.
Payoff pitch. Chopper off the glove and it ricochets right to Sturris. One out. Walden reaching out for it, deflecting it.
And so often you see that ball go off the pitcher's glove and goes into the outfield, but reflect the rate that Meister is in position to make that play, get that first out.
And staying away from Cruz's hot zone, staying away from him, inducing that ground ball out. Here's Moreland, who's 1-for-3, had a base hit in the second. And then his last two plate appearances went down swinging against Jared Weaver. The biggest one was in the sixth inning with the bases loaded. That fastball is a strike. No one pitch. 0-2 now. Dowling that one up to 98 last night, hitting triple digits. They jammed him, fouls it back. The count remains at no balls, two strikes.
You see Jeff Mathis pitch before, frames an outside fastball. This time wants a pitch up in the strike zone and gets it. Catcher, such an important part of the equation as far as good pitch ball games.
1-2 count. Three. This one lifted in the air to left. Howie Kendrick back a couple of steps. Two outs. Halos one out away from picking up the victory here, picking up a game on the Texas Rangers. The former Angel himself, Mike Napoli, stands in the way of finishing this one off. The first pitch is a strike on the outside corner, 0-1. Napoli 0-for-3 today with a strikeout, a pop-up, and a line-out. That line-out was the one that Piasco went up the ladder and got leading off the seventh. Yeah, one pitch outside, one ball, one strike. 1-1 pitch, fouled straight back. Fastball at 99 miles per hour.
Well, went right after him with that fastball. Napoli was on that fastball, though. Napoli very good as far as high fastballs. Great opportunity to be able to throw that nasty electric slider to get the swing and miss.
$38,315 here at the Big A. The majority of which on their feet. 1-2 upstairs. 2-2 now. Walden trying to finish it off for Jared Weaver. Looking for his 13th win of the season. 7th shutout innings for Weaver. The 2-2 pitch. This one broken bat flare out to center field, and that is going to fall in for a base hit. The barrel of the bat ends up near the mound, and Napoli is on board with a two-out knock.
Boy, went with a fastball away. Great location, shatters the bat. Napoli is so strong, he's able to fight that into the outfield for a flare base hit.
Craig Gentry will pinch run for Napoli over at first base. Gentry with very good speed. Mike Butcher is going to come out, talk things over with Walden. 16 pitches thrown by Jordan here. Andy Chavez, a center fielder, will be the batter. He's 0 for 3. He's popped out to second, struck out, and popped out to Trumbo in foul territory. Guy that is always looking fastball in, trying to cheat on it.
And rule of thumb, stay to the outer half, utilize the bigger part of the ballpark.
Callaspo playing in at third base. Glance over to Gentry. 11 stolen bases for Gentry. Has not been caught stealing. First pitch to Chavez. Swing and a miss. So light. Bar shading Chavez up the middle. The outfield deep from left to right. Kendrick, Trout, and Wells. In the bottom right of your screen, you see Ian Kinsler. He's the leadoff man. He stands on deck. Two outs here in the ninth. 0-1 pitch. Outside. One ball, one strike. These two have never faced each other. Andy Chavez and Jordan Walden. Chavez with very good speed. Gentry takes off. The pitch is lifted foul and out of play. And it's a one ball, two strike count as Gentry will head back to first.
Bottom line with Jordan Walden right here with that type of stuff you have. Yes, you just hold the baseball. Slow down, Gentry to first. But you have to think in terms of the batter. Don't speed up your delivery. Utilize your great stuff.
Gentry again with a pretty good lead. Takes off the 1-2, is upstairs. No throw for Mathis because that pitch was so elevated. How much Mathis could do after to go up and get it. Gentry picks up his 12th stolen base.
Boy, a big jump right there. Another tough one to be able to even catch.
The 2-2. Outside, full count.
And we see the outfield formation change now to bringing them in. They're pushing left field and center field.
Payoff pitch, grounded towards short, backhanded by Ibar, gets rid of it quickly, right down. Shut out the Texas Rangers, take 2 of 3, the final 1-0.
Well, that man at shortstop is one of the best in all of baseball. That is a very difficult play that Eric Ibar made look easy on the backhand, all-in-one motion to transfer, and that strong throw across to preserve a 1-0 victory. Great job. Win 2 out of 3 against the Rangers. Jerry Weaver set the tone. They were able to scratch a run across on an error in the outfield. Oh, bottom line, coming back in that game last night, 6 runs in the 6th. All of a sudden, the adrenaline going and able to win today, 1-0.
C.J. Wilson, the tough luck loser. He's 10-4. Weaver with the win, 13-4. Jordan Walden with the save. For Mark Gubiza and our entire crew, I'm Victor Rojas. Thanking you for watching Angels Baseball. We invite you to stick around. Angels Live is coming up next.